Utah.
Well, welcome back. We have Dr. Steven Lynch here, urologist at LDS Hospital. And today we're talking about prostate cancer, which is the most common cancer among men, right?
That's correct.
And are we finding more incidents of it, or is it just kind of the same thing all the time?
Well, the incidence has leveled off a little bit, and that was based on PSA testing, which was first developed in the late 80s, the early 90s, and then there was a real steep rise in the diagnosis of prostate cancer, but it's been pretty stable, but it's about 250,000 cases a year, so it's a significant number.
All right, and it's not all that difficult to actually diagnose it, is it? Just last week I went and had a physical, did the blood work, and of course the glove work. And it's actually pretty easy.
Right.
Right.
So that's it. It's just a blood test and a physical examination of the prostate. Pretty easy thing to do. You know, most people recommend that that test be done once a year or every other year. Mm-hmm. And the age range that we focus on are men between the ages of 55 and 70.
And I've heard it said that if you live long enough, you're probably going to have prostate cancer.
You probably are, but you know, not all prostate cancer needs to be treated. Mm-hmm. And so that's the tough thing, is trying to figure out which cancers are significant enough that we should treat them and which ones we should just observe.
I guess a lot of them are like slow producing. There are some aggressive ones, I'm sure.
There are some aggressive, but I would say in our practices, we probably observe 40% of them.
Okay, now what about treatment? What is you probably have a full range of treatments depending on what it is, but.
There are different treatments depending on how aggressive it is, but in general, in the United States, most patients either receive radiation treatment or surgical treatment to remove the prostate. There are other treatments out there like freezing the prostate. You can heat up the prostate, you know, with a high-frequency ultrasound, like a microwave, to heat up the prostate. But by and large, the two main forms of treatment in the United States are surgery and radiation.
Yeah, I'm sure the treatments are getting better and more high-tech. So
they are getting better, and that was, you know, one of the big stigmas in the past was that the treatments have side effects.
Some pretty bad side effects.
They can be significant. Yeah. So we're trying to mitigate those and. We've made some progress there.
Well, Dr. Lynch, thank you very much.
All right.
And the main thing you need to get out of this, get checked. Okay.